Today, we learned all about Elijah's showdown with the prophets of Baal. It's one of the most incredible stories in the entire Bible. But here's the thing that about that story is that it proves that God is God. You see, all those prophets of Baal, they all believed that they were worshiping the one true God. Well, maybe not the one true God, but they were worshiping a real God, and that God that Elijah was serving, he wasn't a God. They actually thought that Baal was better than the God that we serve, the God of the Bible. And so what Elijah did by forcing this showdown is he showed that God is the God. God showed his true power. It was an amazing story and an amazing scene of something that people still talk about today, even though it happened thousands of years later. But here's some important things that we can draw from the story. The first thing is that when I pray, God hears me. You see, with the prophets of Baal, they kept calling out to God. They yelled, they shouted, they screamed, saying, "Baal, please hear us." But Baal couldn't hear them because Baal is made out of wood, maybe even metal, but they don't have ears. But God is a real God. He's a person. Maybe he doesn't look like you and me. He's actually a spirit, but God hears our prayers. And we saw that because Elijah, instead of yelling and screaming and even cutting himself like some of the prophets of Baal did, Elijah whispered. He spoke in a quiet voice and asked for God to hear him and show that he was there. And God answered his prayer. You see, you can have prayers too. You can have prayers, and no matter where you are, whether you say them out loud or you just say them in your head, God hears your prayers. Now, some of you may be thinking, it was like, well, God hears me, but what can he actually do something about it? Well, you have to understand is that nothing is impossible for God. You see, what happens is when people pray to God, they say, God, they ask God for something and then they don't hear anything back, or they don't get an answer to the prayer. And so they think that that means that God actually doesn't listen to them. But God is always listening. Some people think that God won't do it because he can't do it. But God absolutely can, because nothing is impossible with God. God, who created the entire universe, who put everything in motion, who sent fire down and burned up a cow and tons of water and all the wood and everything was gone. That God is the God that we pray to. Nothing is impossible for God. So if you know someone who's sick, or if maybe even if you're sick and you need healing, all you got to do is pray and believe that God will heal you. And now God, he may heal you or he may not, but that's another thing. But what we can do is we know and we can believe that God can do it, because nothing is impossible for him. You can pray to God big prayers, and you might even be surprised at what he answers and what he does. We never know, because God, he's the king over all the universe, and he can do whatever he wants to do. But he also listens to our prayers. The Bible actually says that we are his children. And a person who doesn't believe God, they give good gifts. How much more will our Heavenly Father, who loves you unconditionally, how much more will he give you good gifts as well? And so go ahead and pray. Pray with boldness. Pray full of faith, knowing that God can answer your prayer. Because here's the other thing we've learned from this story, is that our God is the God. You don't hear a lot about other gods that much anymore. You might have some friends that are Muslim and they believe in a God named Allah, and they may even say, well, that's the God, that's the same God, but it's not. You may have some Hindu friends and they have a whole bunch of gods, but that's not the true God. You may have some friends that are Buddhists, and they say that Buddha is a God, but he's not. None of those things are God. Nothing that you worship outside of God is God. God is the God. There's nothing and no one else like Him. He is the only person that we can worship. And God wants to not just be the God, He wants to be your God. He wants you to worship Him. You see, that's why He sent His Son Jesus to die for us on a cross, so that we could have a relationship with Him, so that we would know Him as our Heavenly Father. And God wants to have a relationship with you, and all you have to do is say that you're sorry for the things that, for the wrong things you've done, for the bad things you've done, and promise you won't do them again. And then say that, tell God that He is your God, and you can be saved, and you can have a relationship with Him that can never be broken. And that is amazing. And so what we're going to do now is we're going to worship the Lord. We're going to worship the Lord and worship God because He is the God of the universe. And that's why we're going to sing Our God. It says, our God is greater, our God is stronger, our God is higher than any other. Let's worship Him together as we sing Our God.
Into the darkness you shine.
God, thank you so much. God, that you are the God of the universe and there is nothing impossible for you. God, I thank you that you hear our prayers no matter where we are, what we're doing, or even what language we speak. God, you hear us. And God, I thank you that nothing is impossible with you. We pray right now, big prayers, prayers that may seem impossible, God, because we know that you can do it. God, thank you for being our God. It's your name we pray. Amen.